Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making dressing balls, and I'm making this as part of the Thanksgiving dinner. So you might consider these as Thanksgiving dressing balls. I do have dressing in Betty's Kitchen already, and it's under the name of cornbread sage dressing. And I made it in the format where you put it in a rectangular baking dish and you just scoop it out. And you have your dressing to go with your turkey and gravy and everything else. But some people like to serve it in balls. And so that's what we're going to do. We're going to mix up a mixture that is really cornbread, only it's going to have a little extra stuff in it. And then we're going to bake that in the oven, bring it out, crumble it up, and put a few more things with it, form it into balls. And then you can freeze it at that point if you want to. So this is really a good make-ahead recipe, or you can bake it when you have it in the form of balls. I will be baking some to show you what the finished result looks like. So let's start with a large bowl where I have already beaten two eggs. So we have two eggs that are well beaten. And to that I'm going to be adding some dry ingredients. Here we have 2 cups and one more, 3 cups altogether of self-rising cornmeal mix. So we'll just put that in. We'll be having more liquid, so I'm not really going to worry about stirring yet. That might just ball up. I'm putting in 1/4 cup of all-purpose flour. So this doesn't have to be self-rising. It could be. It doesn't matter. But just 1/4 cup of flour goes in there. Some other dry ingredients. You need sugar, 1 tablespoon of sugar, salt. You need 1 teaspoon of salt. And then just a pinch of baking soda. I measured out 1/4 teaspoon. So you can put something like that in. Now in with this, we're going to put our liquid. And I have 3 cups of regular milk here, but I prefer buttermilk. So what I'm going to do is make this into buttermilk by adding lemon juice. That's a good substitute. If you don't have buttermilk on hand, just use regular milk, and for each cup, put 1 tablespoon. So I'm measuring out 1 tablespoon of lemon juice from concentrate. So there's 1, 2, and the 3rd one. So that will interact with some of our dry ingredients to make the cornbread rise properly, and it'll be a little bit better than just using regular milk. So this is going to go in, and then we'll be able to stir pretty well. It makes a large batter. And this will make a large number of dressing balls, and that's why it's so nice for you to maybe make it early and freeze some, but you can test it because you can see what it's going to taste like early. So this is going to take a little stirring around. Let me go ahead and add the other things, and then I'll just be stirring. I have 1 cup of diced celery, and this is kind of a fine chop. So that's 1 cup going in. And I have onion, and we have 3/4 cup of finely chopped onion. And then one more item is some melted butter. I have 3 tablespoons of melted butter. Just use the microwave to melt it. That goes in. And now it will take me a minute or so to stir this. You want to stir it well. And you might notice I have a greased skillet here. I was going to pour it in there, but it's probably going to have cooled down. So I think I'll go away and get this heated up again, get this mixed, and then I'll pour that in. Then we'll be baking this in the oven at 450 degrees for about 30 minutes. So I think I can go ahead and do all of that and get it done and show you the result. I left my cornbread in the oven for 20 minutes. And you can see I have this one large 10-inch pan, which I didn't want to fill any fuller than that because I felt like it would run over in the oven. And so I needed an extra one, a small one here, and I even had another one which I set aside. We might eat some of that, or we might just put it all together because it is part of the recipe. I want to show you what I've done so far. I got the cornbread. I'm gonna call it cornbread. It has onion and celery in it. It's kind of the pre-dressing mix. I got that out of the oven and I spread it out in this large baking dish. And the purpose was so it could cool down so I could work on it fairly quickly. Now I'm going to show you what happens at this point. So this is after you bake your cornbread and you have it cooled and you can actually work with it and make balls to put in a variety of pans that I've set out here. I'm going to start over here. So I have this one already greased and ready. I just used spray oil for that. One thing I have sitting here is some chicken stock or chicken broth, and it's 14 ounces worth. I'm going to put one can in a pot. And I probably will need more than one can. I need two or three or even more. I'm going to check on the consistency of the ball as I form that and put it into the baking pan. With this can of chicken soup or chicken broth, I'm going to put in cream of chicken soup. So this is a 10.75 ounce can of chicken soup. What I need to do is get these blended together. So I'm going to go to the stove, and this does heat it up a bit, but it doesn't have to boil. It just needs to be blended. And then I'll come back and I have a couple more ingredients to add. Then we'll start forming the balls. Now what I have here is the combination of the cream of chicken soup and also the chicken broth, one can. And it's just warm. I didn't boil it. I just wanted to get it blended together, so it's together. Now before I add that, and I do want to warn you that I probably will be adding a lot more chicken broth, but I want to start with the minimum amount and see where that gets me and then just keep adding until I'm satisfied. Before I add that, I have an ingredient here which is herb seasoned stuffing mix. So this is 1¾ cups and that goes in here and will get mixed in. And eventually I'll be mixing with my hands because I'll be forming balls. So you don't need to worry too much about things looking like they're not going together very well. Now we have sage right here, and this is why I usually call these cornbread sage dressing balls, but I didn't want to repeat my name cornbread sage dressing from last year, so we're just calling these dressing balls this year. I put this out under my hand usually. Now this is what is labeled as rubbed sage when you buy it at your grocery store. But I still rub it again with my hands because that's what gave it the name of rubbed sage. You cause a lot of the oils to activate, and that gives a lot of flavor that you wouldn't get if you didn't work with it just a little bit. So that's going to be mixed throughout. Again, with my hands eventually. Now I'm going to pour in this mixture of chicken broth and cream of chicken soup, and we'll just try to do that fairly evenly. And this is basically what your dressing is like, and when you get it liquid enough, then you could bake it like this, although this is kind of a lot. It's going to make a lot of balls when I get them formed. Let me show you what it would be like if you try using a spoon. Of course, I would need a bigger bowl to do very well with this, but it just kind of is like working with something that is very dense. So what I would do is probably add some more chicken broth before I even get my hands dirty. And I have a can right here, so let's open that. And put that in. And I'm sure you'll need at least this second can, and then we'll go from there. It does take a while for the cornbread to actually soak up the chicken broth, but you can stir if you want to with a spoon, but eventually it's going to come down to getting in with your hands. And you feel the texture of it, And when you get it mixed really well, getting all that sage to every part of it, then you start making your balls. So when you are ready, you're going to have something that looks about like that. Now I'm not ready, so I'm going to go away and just keep mixing this and add more broth if I need it. I don't think I will, because this seems pretty mushy right now. And if you want to bake this, you want it mushy. But if you want to make balls out of it, then you don't want it too liquid. So I'll work with it, and I'll come back and tell you what I've done. I'll show you the result. I have all of the balls rolled, and I would like to show you what I do, because I have a little bit left over here. I've got two pans that are ready. Each of them got sprayed with cooking oil spray, and there are 15 here, 15 over here, so that's 30, and there are 6 here, so I could have used a smaller pan. There is a little bit, enough to make one, and it's actually a large one, so I probably would pinch off a little bit of that and then roll it up. And I like to roll this by hand. I know a lot of you would use something like this ice cream scoop. That guarantees that they're all the same size, but to me it's a little institutional. And this to me says homemade, rolled by hand, and so on. So we would just put it there with the rest of it. What I'm going to do is take this one to the oven and bake it at 375 degrees, and it just has to bake until these are brown and crusty on the outside, because everything is done. And I've already tasted them, they taste delicious, so that's not going to be a problem. Now with what I have left over, here's my tip for you. You can do these ahead of time, and when you get them in this form, you can take aluminum foil and just make sure it's tightly wrapped around. And if it's going to stay for more than a week in the freezer, then I would wrap it again with aluminum foil. But if it's just going to be a week or so, within the week you're going to have Thanksgiving, then just crunch it around the edge tightly. Go all the way around. Don't mash anything. Get to the other side. Make sure you have enough so that it is completely sealed around there and around here. So hopefully you have a big enough freezer and you've cleaned it out enough that you can have room for stuff like this. But it's really helpful to have these done ahead of time. Just bring them out and thaw them. And what I do is I put them on the counter on the morning that I plan to use them. If I'm going to have an afternoon meal, you have to give enough time for them to thaw, because you don't want to put them in the oven with them frozen in the center. You might put them in the refrigerator the day before, and that will give them time to thaw out. These dressing balls have just come out of the oven. I baked them at 375 degrees for 12 minutes, and then I turned them on to broil, because they weren't quite as brown as I would like, but I knew they were done. And this is what they look like, and what we're going to do is to serve them onto a plate like this. Of course, we have 15 on this cookie sheet or baking dish, and if you have all 36 that this recipe makes, then you're going to have a couple of these dishes, maybe three of them, or one big platter. So I'll get these placed, and then I'll come back and take a taste for you. I'm going to take one of these on my little serving dish here, and we'll check them out. Just a little bite. You can see the consistency. Well, let me just break it open for you. It's good dressing. Be wonderful besides the mashed potatoes and gravy over both of them. That's kind of the way we serve them. But let me take a taste. It's so flavorful. You wouldn't think that that big mess of cornbread and celery and onions would come out with this much flavor, but it's partly the herb-flavored stuffing mix that I put in, and also the sage. It's really tasty. I think you'll like it. And also, using dressing balls is very convenient when you want to count the number of people that are going to be served. Like if you have 36 people coming, this would be perfect if you plan for them to have one serving each. I honestly like the kind you dip out better. So I do have that kind in Betty's Kitchen. If you want to look up sage cornbread dressing, then that's the kind you scoop out on your plate. But these taste a lot the same, but they're very good and I think you'll enjoy them.